Defiance takes place in 1941 in Belorussia, or modern-day Belarus. The movie depicts a true story based on a novel by Nechama Tec, and so that's what I'll be basing my analysis on. Defiance covers the story of a forest-based Jewish partisan camp responsible for saving over 1,236 Jews in German-occupied territory during World War II. This makes it one of the most successful rescue operations of the Second World War. So the Germans arrive at the Bielski Brothers' farm, and here we see their parents get killed by the Germans, and the rest of the Jewish civilians being sent away, presumably to ghettos. These events are somewhat accurate. Our main characters, the Bielski Brothers, ran to Stankovitz, where their family owned a mill. Unlike what's being shown in this scene, the Bielski Brothers' parents were actually killed months later in December of that year, not immediately like what's being shown. And no, there's no historical evidence that both brothers or any of the brothers were present when their parents were captured. Instead, the brothers most likely fled deep into the forest before they could be captured by the Germans. The boy we see here is Aaron. There is no historical account that Aaron stumbled across a mass grave like what we're shown. But what we do see here is most likely a reference to a real massacre that took place near Lida, Belarus. Tuvia, one of the Bielski brothers, breaks into the collaborator's home. The man seen here by the dinner table is responsible for the death of Tuvia's parents. And so Tuvia decides to kill him and pretty much all of his family members. This whole revenge-killing plot simply never happened. The Bielski brothers did break into a police officer's home, but that was not for revenge. Instead, it was for guns and ammunition. That being said, it's a common misconception that the only person turning in Jews were Nazis or SS officers. Many times, it was actually the friends, associates, neighbors, or whatever of the Jews that turned them in.
For my parents, David and Bella Bielski. For my brothers, and for all the others.
This is Lila. Lila is my forest wife.
I see. Congratulations.
Like most movies these days, there's a romanticized love affair in this film. The brothers were accused of using their positions of power to take advantage of women. In truth, the love affair between the brothers and their wives are more passionate than reality. There are also a few minor mistakes, like Zeus falling in love with a girl named Sonia, while in reality he fell in love with a girl named Bella.
Hello, Haya.
Hello, sorry.
Let me take.
Oh, no, no, I'm fine. Sure, I can. I'm fine. Thank you. May I help you?
Haya, I was wondering if maybe you, I mean, you and I, if we...
I accept.
The policy of diplomacy is shit. Winter is coming, and now we have no shelter. Why? Because you don't have the stomach to do what must be done.
We see Zeus and Tuvia argue over what to do at the camp. Zeus wants revenge and more actions against the Germans, while Tuvia prefers to focus more on survival. Eventually, Zeus decides to abandon the camp and join the partisans for revenge. What actually happened is that Tuvia and Zeus never had this disagreement with each other. In fact, the Jewish camp actually worked alongside the Russian partisans to fight against the Germans. The camp would eventually split up, but not for the reasons shown.
Achtung, Achtung! Alle Juden sofort zusammenbleiben.
Tuvia did want to recruit more people, but he didn't go to the ghetto himself. And that makes sense, because it would have been incredibly stupid for the leader of a resistance group to walk straight into German hands. Instead, Tuvia sent him messages encouraging Jews to leave the ghetto, then he sent his own men to lead the Jews out.
As they were. Fire!
You know, if you're gonna teach her how to shoot, teach her how to shoot. Tell her to stick her frickin' elbow down.
Медикаменты только для бойцов.
Если у нас в лагере перспектив, он ведь к вам перекинуться может.
Придется рискнуть.
Я категорически настаиваю,
товарищ командир.
Лучше не надо.
Подождите. Станкевич в полицейском штабе. Вы должны быть медикаменты.
The Bielski brothers actually had to deal with typhus. However, they did not raid a police station. Honestly, they'd probably just added the scene to put more action scenes in the movie. The Jews managed to capture a German soldier and beat him to death. This simply never happened. The movie ends with the final battle scene, which never happened. And as far as battle scenes go, this one's done pretty poorly. I mean, just watch this.